going over how to make a more complicated style tree. Now, in our last video, we made a simple tree, which was basically using a tree stamp. And on that tree stamp, we covered it with a shadow layer of leaves, then the mid-tone color of leaves, and then highlights. And overall, it made just your basic 2D graphic tree that's a good-looking style. And you can change up the style by making the shape different, as well as changing the colors. You can also use different stamps and different types of leaves, so it's very universal when it comes to making any sort of stylistic game tree. So for this one isn't so much for your like 2D game tree that you would like have on an open map where like you're running and it's like a platform game and you would just run by some trees. Those type of trees were the ones we made in the last video. This one would be kind of like a tree you would see in a graphic on the home screen, on the menu page. It looks a little bit more fancy. It looks a little bit more put together. So this one is something that you'd see in like a still graphic, not so much a background graphic in game. So step one is actually going to be going to Chrome. What we're going to do is just look up tree. And then you can go into images. Now, you want to find basically a tree bark texture. So that's getting close because we kind of see some texture there. And some of these might have copyright issues. So that's when you want to go to a website called Pixels. Well, Pixels. It's like Pixels without the I. And everything here is free. It's all stock. And it's high quality. So we're just going to check if they have any sort of up close. This one's pretty up close, but not quite up close enough. So you're just going to search in for sort of like a tree style that you would like. I recognize that tree. That tree is the stamp from the software I use. There's a stamp of that exact tree. It's really funny. Okay, this is a really good up close. So let's just get this up close. So you're just going to download it. So you're just going to download it. Go back over to Affinity. Affinity Designer is a software I am using, as you know if you've watched my previous videos. Drag and drop it in. Alright, there we go. Okay, so we have this tree right here. So, now it does have this going out across it, which is kind of a bummer. Because that's going to show up, but just try to find an image that maybe doesn't have that. Just the bark itself, but it doesn't really matter because this is just kind of going over the steps like for demonstration purposes. So basically, what I would do is you come in and you select this tool, your tracing tool, just the it's like a tracing line tool, and you just kind of trace the outside of the tree, just kind of getting the overall shape of it. So we're just going to come in here, just kind of getting those rough outlines, because if we just kind of made a box around it, that wouldn't be realistic. We need to get all these little subtle details for our final product tree, because if we don't, it's not going to look realistic. You don't have to be precise, just make sure you don't overlap the background. You just want to stay within the tree. So if there's a little tree on the outside, that's okay, as long as you're not getting any of that background. Because you just want the tree. That's all we're wanting right now. And if you want to, you can be like super detailed and go in and trace it perfectly. But honestly, it doesn't have to be perfect. You're just trying to give it a nice, natural jagged rough edge like a normal tree would have. Okay, we don't have to trace the other side because the other side won't be shown. It's coming in from the left side of the image anyway. So then holding down shift, that makes a perfect line, as you can see. And I'll just click here, shift again, and then attach it. So now I have this block, it's behind it's not. It's in front. It's just not filled in. There we go. Okay, what is happening? Okay, there we go. Alright, we have this black box. So now what you're going to do is you're going to hold down Option. Click on the object and just pull it apart. So you duplicated it, which you can also do by right-clicking. And then you can duplicate it within here, which I never actually use this way to duplicate things. I was just holding down the Option. It is in here somewhere, but just hold down Option and pull it away, and you'll duplicate it. So now that you have another one, this will be our base layer, and this will be our textured layer. So if you come over here to layers, you'll see our picture and our two things that we made. It's very simple so far, right? We've literally just traced the tree. That's it. We've just traced the tree. And then we colored it in black. It doesn't have to be black, but we'll do it for black right now. Now, this one, the base layer one, put it at the bottom. Because what you want is you want the picture of reference and then the tracing at the very top. Everything in this facility has to be below it. So this and this have to be at the very top. Now, click on your image. Copy, paste, arrange, move to front. All you've done is you've just made a copy of the image and you've put on top. And you have sandwiched your tracing in between. So you got your base layer. Then it's important to have your image, tracing image. That's what you want. You want a sandwich at the very top. Nothing should be above it. So if anything's above it, it's not going to work. It needs to be below. So, image, tracing image. Now click on the top image. And you're going to come down here, this little circle with a slash, and click on black and white. So now this image is black and white. Now click on it again, and this time press levels, and you're going to bring up the darks and bring up the whites to get as much contrast as you can. So basically, look, if it's too white, there's hardly any contrast. It's mainly all white. So now do you see how much texture there is? See, not much texture, lots of texture on that tree. So you just want to bring it up as much as you can, but not over. You want as much texture, so that's a lot of texture. So now that you have a lot of texture, right, on the top one, you got your tracing in between, and then you got the original one below it, right? You got the original one below it. Whoops, I just undid my tracing. I mean, my texturing, it's okay. It only takes a minute just to really kind of... Alright, there we go. Okay, so... we got the sandwich. The top one has been converted into black and white. It's got a lot of texture on it from adjusting the levels. Now click on it, the top one. Right click. And you want to do something called rasterize to mask. Rasterize to mask. Okay, so press that. Now it's gonna look all weird and wonky. Come over to your layers panel, right click, and you're gonna right click on the top one again. Right click on it over here, and then go mask to below. And now click on where your tracing is and pull it away. Click on the image below and delete it. Now you have this texture. So now click on your base layer, and your base layer, let's make it, it's going to have to be darker, so let's do like a darker brown. Then for this texture, let's make it, a lighter brown. That looks pretty good. Now just, what you want to do is bring this up. To where you have, okay, this side will work pretty well, okay, and if you notice, it doesn't cover all of it, because originally, when I masked it, some of the image was off of the page. Whatever's off the page, it will not be in the final thing, so you want to make sure all of it, all the image, all the tracing is within this white box, and and some of it wasn't, so that's what happened. It's cut off. So now, anyway, put it on top of your base layer. Okay, so let's just match it up. That looks about right. So now you have this texture here. So if you're not happy with the gradient, click up here, and let's try to think if the sun was over here, the color would probably be lighter, right? And then it would be darker on the other side. So now we kind of have that. So now we have this tree, and then because there was that thing hanging over, now we have this really ugly thing. And so that kind of ruins this one piece, but you get the idea. But there's more that you can do to this. What you can do is bring out your base layer again. Just copy it and paste it over here. So your original base layer is still underneath, right? And then bring it over here, okay? Now, what we're going to do is go back into Google. And this time, let's look up moss. Let's find a good moss texture. If you can't, what you can do is just look up moss texture. Go into images. Getting a lot of stuff here. Okay, this looks pretty good. There's no copyright stuff on it. So save image as. Save. Now we're just gonna plop it in. Oh, here. Okay, there it is. And let's just bring it up. It will drop in quality, but it's okay, because you're not going to be seeing too much of it anyway. So now that we have this, we're doing the same process, but I'll do it faster this time. So bring up your treesing. Okay. Let's fit all of it in this time. Okay. It's just really your tracing that to be inside, but I'm gonna make this smaller too so the moss looks smaller. Okay. So select both and we're gonna send them to the front. We're gonna take our image, copy, paste, send to front. So now we have the sandwich with the moss outlined moss. Okay. And we're gonna click on the moss. We're going to click on black and white, click on levels, and just get some of that good texture going on. That looks really good. Now, click on it, rasterize the mask, go over here, right click on the top one, the one that's black and white, rasterize to mask, oh wait, whoops, already is, right click, mask to below, take this off, delete that. Now we have this, and we shrunk it, so now we need to bring it back up to its original height, which is still not quite there. An easy way to do this is just copy and paste this base here, and click, and let's see, let's just turn this to white for now so we can get an idea how big it was before. So the same size. So now let's bring it over here. Put on top. Let's make it green. Like a nice green. Okay, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring down the opacity of it. let's make it a darker green. Now this will look better if your moth's image is curved. This is flat, so it adds a flatness to it, so as you can tell, it doesn't look the best. But once again, I'm giving you an idea of how to overstack textures so you can kind of like add some stuff to your tree. Okay. Delete that. So now you kind of have like this tree right here. And we're just going to add a back layer. And let's just make it a blue. It's a pretty lavender. Simplified version of this. If I was actually doing this for a graphic, I would find much more of a tree, like bigger tree, trace more of it. I will show you an example right now. Okay, right now you should be looking at an example. If the tree on the right, the one that's in the foreground, that was made with the same process, same with the stones. The stones are tracing of actual stones, then converted the same way and given gradients, and then I made the divots inside of them just using basic shapes with gradients and dropping the opacity. And then you add in your grass with the grass stamp and the background trees with the stamps. And it's really simple, but you can get some crazy cool stuff. So yeah. Anyway, I hope you all enjoy this video.